Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be explaining direct sequence spread spectrum. So I'll continue with my previous session where I have explained frequency hopping spread spectrum. So that was analog technique of spread spectrum. Now in this session, I'll explain direct sequence spread spectrum. So that is what digital spreading technique of spectrum. So to explain this, these are my session outlines where first I'll explain basics of spread direct DSSS, significance of it, block diagram of it, how it works, and by waveforms I'll explain how it generates signal. Then we'll discuss bandwidth sharing of DSSS, advantages and applications of DSSS. So let us begin this session with first point, that is basics of DSSS. So when we talk about basics, it is a spreading technique which extends bandwidth of input signal. So here our agenda is like, see, if we have input signal, right, let us say this is input signal and its bandwidth is this much. Let us say its bandwidth is B. So after having a process through DSSS system, you'll be finding its bandwidth of output signal, so that will be larger than this. So if I say this is what BSS bandwidth, so this bandwidth that will be very larger than this bandwidth. So this is what our ultimate agenda. And here input signal can be modulated in terms of PSK, QPSK and QAM. While we have discussed in previous session frequency hopping spread spectrum, where we can have only FSK modulation technique, but in this DSSS modulation technique we can have phase shifting, quadrature phase shifting and quadrature amplitude modulated signal. So these are the techniques which is efficient than the technique which is there with FHSS, frequency hopping spread spectrum, where we were been using FSK. So this is what one basic advantage which we have it in DSSS. But when we talk about frequency hopping spread spectrum, that was analog spread spectrum method, while this DSSS, that is what digital spread spectrum technique. So agenda is same. In spread spectrum we increase bandwidth of input signal, but in DSSS we will be having digital spectrum technique. And here modulating signal could be PSK, QPSK and QAM, and agenda is to increase bandwidth. So this is what the basic which is there with DSSS. Now why do we go for DSSS, direct sequence spread spectrum? So as we have seen in previous session, in analog spread spectrum we use FHSS, frequency hopping spread spectrum, and it has following drawbacks, and those drawbacks are non-coherent detection. So that is what the basic issue which was there with FHSS, and for that we need to have only FSK, DPSK technique at input side. And because of that, bit error rate is poor and bandwidth efficiency is poor. So to increase bit error rate and bandwidth efficiency, we go for DSSS. And to understand that how we perform DSSS operation, let us have a block diagram of it. So I'll explain DSSS by basic block diagram. So first of all, let us have original signal. So here we have original signal. Now this original signal that we can modulate in different methods. Here I'm modulating it with respect to phase shifting. We can have PSK, QPSK. So here one can use PSK, QPSK, QAM. So these are efficient method. So out of that we can use any. So here I'm using PSK. So now your signal, original signal, that is there in terms of phase shifting. And then all we do is we give it to spread error. So here we have spreader. or one can say modulator, and that modulator that is modulating this PSK signal, and it is amplifying bandwidth of it. And here there will be chip generator, and that is generating chip signal based on PN sequence. So here you will be having PN sequence. So this PN sequence that is been given, that is giving signal to chip generator, and that chip generator that is actually defining bandwidth of it. Like, see, for example, if I say here PSK signal that is having bandwidth B, and if this chip generator that is generating chip signal with length L, so whatever signal that is there after having modulation, that is a signal which is DSSS signal, and if I say its bandwidth is BSS, then that bandwidth will be L times of B. Now this L, that is what? Bandwidth multiplication factor, or one can say processing gain. L is processing gain, and that L that we can define by TB divided by TC. Now what is TB and what is TC? So TB is bit period and TC is chip period. So to understand this bit period and chip period, I'll explain how we can calculate that by waveforms. Now see here, this chip generator that is generating codes. So this chip generator, it generates codes. Here one can use Barker codes even. So chip generator can use, it can have Barker codes. So in Barker codes there are total 9 different codes which is softly used in this DSSS. I'm not going in detail of Barker codes. If somebody is asking, then in future I can make separate session based on Barker codes, but it uses Barker codes, and you'll be finding its output that is there in terms of digital. So it has digital output, and that output that may be there in terms of +1 and -1. So it has digital output, and that is there in terms of +1 and -1. So original signal, that is what we are modulating in terms of PSK, QPSK, QAM, it is having bandwidth B. Then spread error, that is what magnifying bandwidth of it, resultant output will be DSSS. And here we have chip generator that is been given with input of pseudo code. So chip generator generates a chip signal which is there in terms of +1 and -1, and resultant code, that is DSSS code, which is digital one. Now let us try to understand how those things are happening by waveforms. So if I say I have input signal that is 101, so my input signal is 101. Now here, as I have told you, this is what chip generator that is having length L. So if I say I have spreading code that is having length phi, so L is equals to phi that I am using right now, and that code is 01011. So for one bit, this phi bits that is there with this spreading code, for another zero, this phi bits are there with this spreading code, and for another one, this 5 bits are there in spreading code. So 0 that is assigned with -1 voltage, and 1 that is assigned with +1 voltage. So 0 that is assigned with -1 voltage, and 1 that is assigned with +1 voltage. So this is my spreading code. Now, what will be output code? So output code, that will be XORing of input signal and spreading code. So output code, now output code, that is XORing of input and spreading code. So here input is 1, spreading is 0. So that will be resulting into 0. Here input is 1, spreading is 1. So 1, 1, XORing will be 1. So XNORing operation that we do here. Not XORing, XNORing operation. Now see 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. 1, 1, 1 and 1, 1, 1. Now see here, this is 0 and this is 0. So XNORing that will be 1. So here it will be 1. 0, 1 that will make it to 0. 0, 0 that will make it to 1. 0, 1 that will make it to 0. Now 1, 0 that will make it to 0. 1, 1 that will make it to 1. 1, 0 that is 0 and 1, 1 that is 1 for XNORing. So one can see this is what our output code. Now see here this is input signal and this time period, that is bit time period TB. Here this is what bit time period TB. And as per spreading code, this time period, that is TC, chip time period. So this is chip time period TC. So ultimately, if you observe our DSS signal, so that is having bandwidth, that is L times of B. So if I say what is L, so L has to be bit time period TB divided by chip time period TC. So that is how processing gain that we can calculate based on this. So bit time period, that is what a time period of input signal bits, and based on spreading code time period of bit, that is TC. So TB by TC, that is processing gain L, and that L will justify BSS bandwidth. So that is spreaded bandwidth, that is L into input bandwidth B. So ultimately we can increase bandwidth digitally here. So now one can understand, this is how we can digitally amplifying bandwidth of input signal. Now let us move on to next point, that is bandwidth sharing of DSSS. So see, in wireless LAN it is not possible to share bandwidth by using DSSS, but by using Barker code we can share it in some applications. So if you use Barker code, you can share bandwidth of particular channel with other channel even. That is possible, but it is little complex. But in wireless communication, it is extremely difficult to share bandwidth here. Advantages are better security than frequency hopping spread spectrum, and it is having better immunity against jamming compared to FHHS. And applications are like, see, in CDMA for 2G as well as 3G, DSSS, direct sequence spread spectrum, is been utilized. So this is how DSSS is so important in digital communication. I hope that you have understood this, and you can definitely ask some questions if you have any doubt here. I'll try my level best to solve all those queries which is there with you. And you can suggest me those things which is required here in digital communication. I'll try my level best to explain all those things. Thank you so much for watching this video.